Blue and Gray 2014 here today. Today I'm going to show you guys a video of the LG G Stylo from Boost Mobile. This is a remarkable device. The price was $175 in the month of November to December. This device features a 5.7-inch display, an 8-megapixel back-facing camera, a 5-megapixel front-facing camera, autofocus, and a flash on the back, and it also has a speaker. On all the sides of the phone, there is nothing there. It has a headphone jack and the stylus. For the price of this phone, it is an amazing phone. I have had this phone since December of 2015. This phone has been remarkable to me. It has kept up with all of my latest Facebook, Instagram, Kick, and Snapchat, and Twitter. It has helped me learn how to do so many more things with a phone than I ever knew I could do. The phone runs very, very smoothly with its quad-core processor. It does have 6.0 Marshmallow. Service on this phone is absolutely amazing. I can walk anywhere or drive anywhere and have LTE service all throughout my driver walk. Also features a stylus, which is very handy when you need it. It only controls the stylo. As far as I've tried, the only phone that I could barely get it to work with was the iPhone 4S. In the settings, you have your hotspot, you have roaming, you have mobile data, you can share and connect, you can tether. The sound is amazing on this phone. There's so many different ringtones to choose from. The Do Not Disturb comes very, very handy for school and work. You can try your font type, your font size, your brightness, your home touch buttons. For my home touch buttons, I have my back button, my home button, my square button, which is tabs, and my multiple screen buttons. You can also change the color of these buttons. They give you options from black to white. Very handy features like night brightness. This phone comes with 8 GB of useful storage. As you can see, mine is probably full because I have a lot of pictures and a lot of family stuff, and I have a lot of apps. I need everyday apps. You can also put an SD card in and move your apps to the SD card. That helps out a lot too. The phone is very slick and sleek. As you can see, it kind of has this curve appeal to it that I really, really enjoy. Easy to fit in the hands, but as it's so big, I have difficulty taking pictures with friends through the front-facing camera because it's kind of hard when you're taking a picture with one hand and you have to click the screen at the same time. The messaging that the LG provides is absolutely great. It sends snappy, fast messages, and you can send up to audio, video, pictures, MP3 files, and more. And on the phone is very crystal clear and easy to access. As you can see while scrolling through Facebook, it's very, very easy. It lags a little bit, but you get used to it, and it doesn't do it a lot. Recent problems with the messaging app for Facebook. It usually lags my phone during the middle of a text message and then it doesn't send. I first got the phone, I put it into color inversion for colorblind people. And once I put it into normal, it was in black and white, and I turned up my brightness and it wouldn't do it too much, and I turned it down and it would do it a lot. But I just waited a few minutes and it stopped. This launcher has done amazing. They have put everything you need in some sort. You can also go to the app menu. You can hide your apps. You can show large icons. You can search for apps and you can uninstall apps. There's also a bunch of widgets. These all come in handy very well when you're at work or school and need to get easy access. The phone takes very real-like pictures. It's almost like a photograph camera. The battery life on this phone is pretty great, but you need to disable some notifications and some sync and location options to save a lot of battery. And Battery Saver is highly recommended to me because it helps my battery save at least 20% every hour. Thank you guys for watching. This is Blue and Gray 2014. Please subscribe and like and comment.